Whoa, that is so dang cool.
Hey everyone, welcome or welcome back. I'm really excited about today's video, and it's honestly one that I've been wanting to make for a really long time now. Today I'm going to show you how you can automatically adjust the text on your Matplotlib figures so that it's easier to read. I find this super useful and I can't wait to show it to you. So today we're going to be looking at a small Python library called AdjustText. AdjustText was created back in 2018 by Ilya Flyamer. It's an open source project, which means it's free to download and free to use, but you can also look through all of the source code because it's provided on GitHub. Now, AdjustText is going to work with Matplotlib, but first you'll need to download it. I did that by executing pip install AdjustText, but you can also get a copy through Conda if you'd prefer. Once that's done, let's go ahead and take a look at AdjustText in the Python code.
So in this video, I'll just show you a brief demo of AdjustText, but if you want to learn more about it, you can definitely check it out on GitHub. So you'll want to go ahead and install AdjustText, and you can do that through pip. I already have it installed, so I'm going to then just go ahead and load it in. And what we want to do here is say from AdjustText, import adjust_text. So this is the main function that we'll be using. It's called adjust_text. I'm also importing NumPy as well as PyPlot from Matplotlib. So let's go ahead and take a look at a basic example of using AdjustText. First, I'm going to create some random data with NumPy. I'm creating X and Y, and both of those are going to have 20 values, and those values range from 0 to 1. Then I'm going to go down here and plot those values with a scatter plot. I'm plotting X and Y, and you'll just see 20 dots on this plot. I'm also going to label those dots with text. So let's take a look at what's happening here. Text is going to be a list. I'm using PyPlot's text function to create these labels. That requires an X and Y position, which I'm just grabbing from X and Y, but I'm also labeling these with strings. So each point is going to be labeled point and then a number. I ranges from 0 to 19. So let's take a look at that plot. So we can see those 20 different data points, and we also have text labels for every single point. But we have a couple of issues here. First of all, I have some text that's outside of my figure. It's just kind of hanging outside, and that's certainly not appealing. The other big issue is that some of my text is overlapping, so it's really hard to tell what number point this one is and what point that one is, right? So AdjustText is actually going to solve for both of these issues. Let's update this figure using AdjustText. It's really quite simple. All we have to do is add one more line of code. We're going to use the AdjustText function, and we'll just pass in text, which is a list of all of those text labels we want to use. We'll execute this cell, and you'll see that we now have text that is not overlapping and is not outside of our bounds. So that's pretty awesome. All we have to do is add one more line of code, and that takes care of the text issues we were having in the previous figure. You'll also see this number show up right here, number 11. That's just telling you that it took 11 iterations to get to the figure that we see here. If you're working with a seaborn figure instead, you can still use AdjustText to update your labels. So let's take a look at that. First, I'm importing seaborn. I'm setting my style to be dark grid, and I'm loading in some data about penguins. I'm going to drop any null values in that data set, and I'm also going to sample down to just 25 observations. So taking a look at my data frame here, we see that we have various different measurements for different penguins. Let's go ahead and create a figure that's a scatter plot with seaborn. So here I'm going to set X to be my bill length series, Y is going to be the bill depth, while the labels variable references our penguin's species series. So note that X, Y, and labels are all pandas series at this point. I'm going to use seaborn to create a scatter plot for these data. I'll set X equal to X, Y equal to Y, and the hue of these scatter points equal to the labels. That just means I'm going to have a different color for every penguin species in this data set. I'm going to increase the size of those dots a little bit, and I'm turning off the legend. Okay. We're also going to add some text to these scatter points. I'm using pretty similar syntax to what I used before, but there is this zip happening, so let me walk you through this. I'm still going to use PyPlot's text function, so that means I need an X position and a Y position along with a string. But now I have that X position, Y position, and label string coming from the zipped pandas series. So let's go ahead and execute that. And now we'll see something that looks kind of similar to before. We have a scatter plot here in the middle, and we have various different labels for each point, but we definitely still have issues here. We have this label hanging outside of the figure area, and we also have several labels that are running into each other. Let's see if adjust text can help this figure. We'll just call up adjust text, and we'll pass in text, which is a list of all of the text labels on our figure. Executing that, we see that we can absolutely use adjust text in conjunction with Seaborn figures. We've updated this label so that it doesn't hang outside of the figure, and we've also updated all of these labels so that we can actually read them. So with that one line of code, we've made this figure look a lot better, and I'm just blown away at how that little adjustment can really help us and save us a lot of time.
So how does adjust text make this magic happen? Well, there's a couple of steps going on. In the first step, it's going to take all of the text that currently falls outside of the figure and move that back in our current axes. Then it's going to go around to each of the different text boxes and count up how many overlaps there are between those bounding boxes and with other points. Then it's going to try to reduce those overlaps by shifting the text in one direction or the other. It'll just continue iterating through this process of measuring the overlaps and shifting to try to avoid overlaps until it reaches a predetermined precision threshold, or it determines that it's failing to converge. And there's a lot more that adjust text can do, like adding arrows or saving those iteration steps as figures. Let's check it out in the Python code.
Let's go back to our data that we were working with before. So X and Y are just random points between 0 and 1. One thing that you might notice is that sometimes when using adjust text, the labels will kind of drift away from the points. So let me show you what I mean by that. If we go down here and we look at points 18 and 1, we'll see that these labels have kind of drifted a little bit from the points that they represent. So this one's actually point 18, and this one's actually point 1, but it's a little hard to see that. So one thing we can actually do is add arrows from the labels back to the points themselves. So to do that, we'll just write in arrow props, and here we're just going to pass in a dictionary of how we'd like these arrows to look. So one thing we definitely have to put in here is arrow style. I'm going to set my arrow style to fancy, but there's lots of different options. I'm also going to specify that the color of these arrows be crimson. And there we go. So now we see these little crimson arrows from every single label to every single point. And this does help let us know that point 18 is actually this one, and point 1 is this one. And there are lots more arguments within adjust text. If you really like this function, I would highly recommend taking a look at the documentation and looking through all of these different options. One of them that I really like is called expand points. So let's go back up here to our scatter plot, and what if we had a really large size marker, let's say S equals 100, which is quite a bit bigger. Now you'll see that some of the text is kind of running into those large markers. So if you'd like to force the text and have it move away from the points even more, you can use this option called expand points. So let's go ahead and try that. And what you're going to pass in here is a tuple. First is how far would you like to expand in the X direction and how far in the Y direction. So the defaults here are 1.05 and 1.2. So I'm just increasing this a little bit. And once we execute that, you'll see that those labels have now been moved even further away from the points. And finally, if you're interested in making a GIF like the one I showed you at the very beginning of this video, you can do that by saving the iteration steps. So to demo this, I'm going to go ahead and make a new directory within my current directory, and we'll call this scatter iter. This is not required, but I do think it's nice. All of these things are going to be saved as individual files, so I'm actually going to save them within one folder. To now save the iteration figures themselves, we're going to go down to adjust text, and we'll now include an argument called save steps. We'll set that equal to true. And because I've created this subfolder within my current directory, I'm also going to set save prefix equal to the name of that folder. So scatter, iter, and then a forward slash. This will just save all of those images within that folder that I just created. So we get the same basic image that we had before, but you'll notice that we now have the number 11 as the figure title by default. So now if I go down here and I list out everything that's in that scatter iter folder, I will see that I have one image for every different iteration of that process. And I can make GIFs from this, or I can just see how much the text is actually adjusting with each iteration. By the way, if I go ahead and open up those images, I'll see that the very first image is my before, and I can go ahead and scroll through and check out how much is changing with each iteration.
So I hope you'll decide to try out Adjust Text. There's even more cool things that you can do, like working with maps or more advanced chart options. I'll put some links in the description bar below so that you can take a look at more examples. A big thank you to Ilya Flyamer for creating this awesome package. And thanks to you, the viewer, for joining me today. If you think that Adjust Text is going to be helpful for you, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. See you next time. I did that by going to...
Hello.